Everything's Flash. Next feature is absolutely sick as well, as most of you probably animate on the timeline and work on it quite a lot. One of the very, very cool features, which I don't know why no one thought about this before, and why wasn't it introduced earlier, is the capability of watching just a small segment of your animation, and repeatedly, if needed. So the new controllers are all these small little controllers that we have down here, and I want to go over them. The basics, really, of the go to the first frame and to the last frame are really easy, obviously, and to go next or back frame. Now, obviously, if you recall, and if you don't, you always have the capability of using your keyboard in your earlier versions to use the comma or dot on your keyboard, dot to go forward, comma to go backwards, or go through your control, and in your control you could step forward or step one frame back. Now, to go to the end and rewind, you can see you have your shift, comma, shift dot. So really, all these functionalities are not new. They were just a little bit more hidden. So I could go to the start frame, end frame, forwards, back, and I could use my enter to start playing and stopping. So far, so good. This is not really new. The new thing that's really, really cool is the capability to loop. So if you click on the loop button is just absolutely awesome. Let's say I just want to see this animation. I just want to see the motion of it coming in to see how it feels. To do that, after I click on my loop button, I could just select the area I want to be able to see. And now when I click on enter to watch it, it's going to run in a loop and only show me that segment over and over. How wicked is that? Obviously, I might have created some epileptic shocks to some people, so apologize for that. Maybe that animation was not one to be repeated in a loop. So let's redeem that by just showing our URL of our site over and over, which is much more fun. Or our copy. And that's about it. So that covers really it. By the way, it works also for motion in the motion editor. So if you created one of the newer animation styles and you're not using classic animations, you could still use it in your motion editor to view and review and watch those segments.